Samadhi is awakening from the dream of the separate self, or the egoic construct. Samadhi is awakening from identification with the prison that I call me. You can never actually be free, because wherever you go, your prison is there. Awakening is not about getting rid of the mind or the matrix. On the contrary, when you're not identified with it, then you can experience the play of life more fully, enjoying the show as it is, without craving or fear. In the ancient teachings, this was called the divine game of Leela, the game of playing in duality. Human consciousness is a continuum. On one extreme, humans are identified with the material self. On the other extreme is samadhi, the cessation of self. Every step we take on the continuum towards samadhi brings less suffering. Less suffering does not mean life is free from pain. Samadhi is beyond the duality of pain and pleasure. What it means is that there is less mind, less self creating resistance to whatever unfolds. And that resistance is what creates suffering. Realizing samadhi even once allows you to see what is at the other end of the continuum, to see that there is something other than the material world and self-interest. When there is an actual cessation of the self-structure in samadhi, there is no egoic thought, no self, no duality, yet there is still the I am, anatta, or no self. In that emptiness is the dawn of prajna, or wisdom. The understanding that the immanent self is far beyond the play of duality, beyond the entire continuum. The immanent self is timeless, unchanging, always now. Enlightenment is the merging of the primordial spiral, the ever-changing manifested world, or lotus, in which time unfolds, with your timeless being. Your inner wiring grows like an ever-unfolding flower as you disidentify with the self, becoming a living bridge between the world of time and the timeless. Merely realizing the immanent self is only the beginning of one's path. Most people will have to experience and lose samadhi countless times in meditation before they are able to integrate it into other facets of life. It's not unusual to have profound insights into the nature of your being during meditation or self-inquiry, only to find yourself once again falling back into old patterns, forgetting the truth of who you are. To realize that stillness or emptiness in every facet of life, every facet of oneself, is to become emptiness, dancing as all things.